It's been a very productive first day of my trip to Europe. We've been focused on solidarity with partners and allies. We're focused on stronger economic ties, jobs, growth, and the middle and support for the middle class, but also, obviously, for standing up for democracy against authoritarianism and standing with Ukraine every step of the way. This morning, I was able to have an audience with Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II at Windsor Castle. We congratulated her, obviously, on the Platinum Jubilee and was able to talk a little bit about the situations we're facing and draw on her long experience for having seen much over these past decades. When I met earlier with Boris, we discussed stronger security ties, continuing to defend our shared values, continuing our work together on advancing free trade and creating more middle-class jobs, and also on climate action, where we need to build a sustainable, secure future. I also had a bilateral meeting with Mark Rutte, where we talked about the enhanced importance of NATO, continuing to work together to fight disinformation and protecting freedom of the press, and continuing to work strongly with our friends in the European Union. But of course, throughout, the focus is on the people of Ukraine and our solidarity with Ukraine, our pushing back against the illegal Russian invasion of Ukraine, and standing up for democracies around the world. Le Premier ministre Johnson, le Premier ministre Rutte et moi avons parlé de notre réponse commune face à la Russie. On se mobilise pour répondre à la crise humanitaire. On insiste pour que la Russie implemente un cessez-le-feu pour protéger la population civile. Et évidemment, on insiste que la Russie met fin à son invasion et quitte l'Ukraine. Canada, UK and the Netherlands are close defense partners. We're working together to mobilize the global community to step up to support Ukraine, and we'll continue to defend democracy and the values that underpin it, and continue to make sure that Putin is held accountable. Today, Canada is announcing new sanctions on 10 individuals complicit in this unjustified invasion. This includes former and current senior government officials, oligarchs, and supporters of Russian leadership. The names of these individuals come from a list compiled by jailed opposition leader Alexei Navalny. These sanctions put increased pressure on Russia's leadership, including on Putin's inner circle. This is, of course, in addition to all the other sanctions we've announced, including our recent announcement on imposing massive tariffs on Russian and Belarusian imports. The work we're doing together is punishing Putin and his enablers where it hurts most, in particular by crippling their financial systems and sanctioning their central bank. So far, in aid for Ukraine, Canada has sent about $1 billion worth of financial assistance and humanitarian aid, but we have more to do. Demain, je serai en Lettonie pour rencontrer le Premier ministre Kairns, d'autres dirigeants et le secrétaire général de l'OTAN, Jens Stoltenberg. For today, we continue to stand with Ukraine, united and strong.